Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I had already completed the course of Criminal Procedure Code for LLB final year and B.A.LL.B. final. However, due to importance of the subject, the chapter 6, it is with regard to processes to compel appearance. It starts from section 68 and ends at section 93. Under section 68, a summon and warrant. Summons are dealt by section 68 to 74, and thereafter the warrant. Summon is a mild form of process. It is an authoritative call to appear in court of law. It may be issued for attendance of a witness to record statement or for a person of some proceeding, or order under section 195, or special summon in case of petty offences under 250. This section applies under all the summons issued under the code. Even a police officer is competent to issue summons to a person to attend investigation. A summon should be in writing. It must be clear and specific in terms of date, time and place. It must be in writing. It must be clear and specific in terms of date, time and place. It must be signed by the presiding officer and shall also bear seal of the court. In case of disobedience, it is for the court to use the powers vested in it. The mode of proof of service, it is necessary that affidavit of serving officer should be made before the court. So far as section 69 is concerned, it provides procedure for service. The law lays stress in personal service to deliver or tendering to address it. One of the duplicate to it. The law required the person receiving summons to sign a duplicate on the back of the duplicate and acknowledge. Where a summon is not served as prescribed by the court, no conviction can be against any person for disobedience of summons under 174 Pakistan Penal Code. A procedure for service of summons on a corporate body provides that it should be served through the secretary, local work manager or other provincial officer of the corporation. In such a case, service through registered post is also admissible. There is presumption of postal service in ordinary courts. If someone in a foreign state can be served through Pakistan embassy officials situated in that country. Section 74 is important. It provides proof of service of someone on the person residing outside local limits of jurisdiction of the court. In such a case, if the person served does not appear or attend the court at the date, time and place specified in the summons, then an affidavit to the effect that the person was served as provided by section 69 or 70. Affidavit of service under 74 is admissible. An affidavit is required for proof of that the summon was served. It is requirement of law that under section 526 and 539 CRPC, affidavit is admissible. There are only three occasions in the Criminal Procedure Code where a person, usually a police officer, to do any particular act such as comprehensive and production of an offender or search of things written, order to arrest under the seal and signature of a court. If someone is always addressed to a person who is required either to attend or produce a document, a valid warrant must be in writing, sufficiently identify the person to whom it is issued. There must be specified offense. Warrant must be issued, must be signed by the presiding officer, must be sealed by the court, must bear the name and designation of the person signing. The form of warrant has been prescribed in Schedule 5, Form Number 2. As per subsection 2, a warrant remains in force until it is cancelled. Section 76 empowers the court to issue bailable warrant. The court may direct by endorsement on the warrant that if person executes a bond with sufficient surety for his attendance before the court at a time specified in the warrant. Section 78 empowers the magistrate first class to direct a warrant to any landholder, farmer or manager of land within his local jurisdiction for the arrest of any escaped convict, proclaimed offender or person who is accused of non-bailable offense. From examination point of view, Section 87 and 88 are very important. Section 87 deals with the absconders. An absconder is a person is concealing himself to avoid his appearance before the court. A person who is aware of his wrong conceals himself secretly. Section 87 prescribes the mode of proclamation. A person absconding the mode of proclamation is prescribed by section 87 and 88 both are very important. The term abscond or conceal has not been defined in the code. However, it occurs in section 87 subclause 1, section 90A and 512 Criminal Procedure Code. The term is also mentioned in section 172 Pakistan Penal Code. The purport of 87.1 is that if any court has reason to believe that any person against whom a warrant has been issued by it has absconded or has concealed himself so that such warrant may not be executed, such court may publish a written proclamation requiring him to appear at specified place, date and time before it. From that, this it is evident that a written proclamation is to be issued only after the court has reason to believe that the person has absconded with the view to avoid the service of the warrant on him. Thus, before issuance of proclamation, the court is to take evidence that the person wanted by it has absconded. So if the accused willingly defeats the process of law to avoid arrest and hides to escape from execution of warrant, there are certain ingredients. Firstly, if someone notice or warrant is issued. Secondly, the same could not be served despite best efforts. Thirdly, process could not be executed due to deliberate avoidance of service by the absconder. Thus, an absconder would be a person who has intentionally evading service to the process of law. The proclamation shall be publicly read in some conspicuous place of the town or village where such person resides. Two, it shall be affixed at some conspicuous place of house where he resides. Three, notice board of the court and at least 30 days time from the date of a publication is to be given to abscond. Section 87 is supplement to Section 80. Section 88 is supplement to Section 87. 87 provides issuance of proclamation. 88 authorize a court issuing proclamation to order attachment of any property of the person declared to be proclaimed offender. Subsection 2 authorizes the court to attach any property in a district within or outside the district. If the property is outside the district, then endorsement of session judge within whose jurisdiction the property is situated is necessary. Subsection 3 provides of if any the property is debt or other movable property, the attachment is to be made. Subsection A provides seizure or appointment of a receiver by an order in writing, probability the delivery of such property. According to subsection 4, if the property ordered to be immovable, attachment is to be made through revenue officer. According to subsection 5, the property consists of livestock or is of perishable nature, the court is authorized to order immediate sale. Subsection 6 empowers the subsection 6 prescribes the powers, duties and liability of the receiver. Subsection 6A to 6D inserted in CRPC through an amendment. These relate to dispose of claim preferred to our objection made to the attachment of property. If the offender appears within specified time, the court may release the property. If the offender does not appear, the property shall be at disposal of provincial